This is Sheshachalam from Astroguide Mysore. Let us discuss today two yogas. Both are the lunar yogas. Both are very important yogas. Analyzing these, both these yogas are very difficult. The second yoga, that the Amala Yoga, which I will be discussing later on, it's a little easier to understand. But the Adhi Yoga, which I will be discussing now, is a tougher yoga to understand. For example, I'll tell you the definition of Adhi Yoga. This is what is called as Chandra Adhi Yoga. From Chandra, that is from Moon, the 6th, 7th and the 8th houses, it's like a garland. So, if Moon is here, the 6th, 7th and the 8th houses, it's like a garland, it's like a pendulum. So, this particular 6, 7, 8, if they are posited with super benefics in the sense, why am I trying to stress that the benefics should be very strong, is because if the yoga has to be strong, the formation of the yoga should be very strong. The yoga can be weak also. If the formation is weak, the yoga will be weak. I'll just give you an example of Adhi Yoga, Chandra Adhi Yoga. When Moon is placed in Pisces, and if you have Leo as the 6th house, Virgo as the 7th sign from Moon, and Libra as the 8th. So, 6, 7, 8. So, in the 6th house, if we have Jupiter, and in the 7th, if we have Mercury, and in the 8th, we have Saturn. Now, people may ask, Saturn is a malefic. Sure, but here in this chart, Saturn acts as a benefic when it is in the 8th from Moon because it is exalted. So, because Mercury is in the 7th, the possibility of Sun very close to is also very important. So, the Sun is in Leo, let us say. So, there is a cluster of benefic planets powerfully posited. So, the Chandra Adhi Yoga will work very strong only when the planets are also, each planet is well posited in the chart. So, there are other possibilities of Adhi Yoga. I'll keep giving you examples here. So, once again, I will repeat the definition of Adhi Yoga. The definition is that when benefics are strongly posited in the 6th, 7th and 8th houses from Moon. So, people can ask, is it also from Lagna? No. Adhi Yoga is Chandra Adhi Yoga. It's only for Chandra. It's only for Moon. So, very clear. So, there are other positions of Adhi Yoga. I'm giving you a second example of Adhi Yoga where actually it makes a very strong placement for this particular yoga's formation. The second formation would happen when Moon is in the Capricorn Rashi. You have an exalted Jupiter in the 7th house. So, for Capricorn Rashi, Capricorn sign, the 6th house falls in the sign of Gemini, the 7th falls in the sign of Cancer, and the 8th is in Leo. So, let us say Gemini, Cancer and Leo are placed with benefics like Mercury, Venus, Jupiter and Mars. Let us say Mars is in Leo, Jupiter is in the 7th house and Mercury and Venus both are in the 6th house, that is in Gemini. This is a very, very strong combination. This person will be valorous, equal to a king, will be a business tycoon, very good in his calculations and his brain. He knows how to do business, he knows how to live his life. He will be equal to a king. That is what has been given in most of the books, like in the Manasagri, in the Brihat Parashara Hora Shastra, in the Paladipika. I have referred all the books for this. So, because this is one of the toughest yogas to understand. Gajakesari is easy to understand if Jupiter is in a quadrant from Moon. But this is not that simple. If only two houses are beneficially posited, that is 6th and 7th are posited and the 8th is maleficially posited, or if there are no planets in the 8th, only two houses are posited, this person is equivalent to a minister. And if it is only one house, then the Adhi Yoga will not fully give fruits at all. It will start but stop abruptly. So we can call this person as a famous person or a person who might have achieved quite a lot, but not to an extent of becoming a minister or what earlier days we were calling these people as divans. So if the 6th, 7th, 8th houses are inclining in strength and declining in strength, this is more important. If the 6th is a little okay, weak, but good planet is there, 7th is a strong planet and 8th is the strongest of the lot. You can see the strength of the planets by doing Shadbala. I will take up Shadbala classes in the later, after the yogas. So, once you see that there is an inclination, there is the ascendant, it's ascending in an order from 6th, 7th and 8th, you can understand that this person will come up from hardship, will achieve great success in his life because of this particular type of combination. If let us say it is declining, so that means this person is born as a king, is having too much of strength in the first half of his life and slowly starts declining. So he comes, let us say, a born a king will become a minister and then become a normal rich person in the world. So he will start losing his status. Increase means he will start increasing in status. So this can be seen from the placement of the planets from moon. So this is called as Adhi Yoga. Let us go into the next yoga, which is one of the strongest karma yogas. And this is Amala Yoga. And why it is a strong karma yoga? Because it refers to the 10th house from both Lagna and Moon. So it is also the Lagna Yoga. So it is also from Ascendant. It is also referred from Ascendant and Moon both ways. So if Ascendant and Moon both are in the same Rashi, that's in the same sign, and have the same common 10th house, then it will be double effect when the 10th house is having a benefic. A simple example would be for a Gemini. So a simple example would be for Gemini Ascendant and Gemini Rashi, that Moon and Ascendant both are in Gemini. We have an exalted Venus in the 10th house. This is one of the strongest Amala Yogas. And also it is giving rise to Malavya Yoga also. So Malavya Yoga, we'll describe it later, it's one of the Panchamahapurusha Yogas. So this is Amala Yoga. So if let us say Lagna and Moon, very rarely it is together. We get one in, you know, 50 to 100 charts where Ascendant and Moon both are present in the same Rashi together. So let us say both are in different positions, then we need to take up an average between the placements from Ascendant and from Moon. That is, the 10th house from Moon is to be understood and the 10th house from Ascendant is to be understood. The strongest will give the result. And it would be an average actually, because the Ascendant represents the physical self of the person. How much of aid this world is going to give him, how much of support this world is going to give him to do his karmas. The second level is Moon, which actually today we are discussing of Amala Yoga. It's both from Lagna and Moon. But why it is important from Moon is that it actually supports you mentally. Your mental faculty, that is your psychological faculty, your emotional faculty, these both will become strong when there is a strong 10th house from Moon. Very rarely we get planets, very rarely we get charts where Lagna and Moon both are in different positions, but both are having very strong 10th houses with good benefic planets. We need benefics here. So the benefics are to be considered as Jupiter, Venus and Mercury, who are the natural benefics. But Tatkalika Mitra or Tatkalika Yogakaraka, that is for that particular chart, Tatkalika Mitra, who is a planet who transforms from a malefic to a benefic, or who is that planet, who is the Yoga Karaka for that particular thing. So if I take up Taurus ascendant, I can't keep telling Jupiter, you know, Mercury and Venus only. Saturn also adds on because he is the Yoga Karaka for Taurus, being the 9th and the 10th lord. So if Saturn is posited in Aquarius for Taurus, one of the strongest Amala Yogas happens. So if it is Taurus Lagna or Taurus Moon, so from there the 10th house is Aquarius. So Amala Yoga is one of the strongest yogas to get into good profession. So people keep asking whether I'll get into a good job like a government job or a private job, whether I'll go abroad. So you should understand who are all the planets who are influencing the Amala Yoga and where they are actually posited. This is one way to understand. That is, if the 10th house is having Jupiter or Venus or any very strong planet, and then if there is an influence on the 12th house, or if the 12th house, the lord of the 12th house is along with that, then there can be a very good job prospect abroad. So we need to, you know, amalgamate all these types of placements and then understand what actually is the inference from this Amala Yoga. Normal inference from Amala Yoga is that this person will have an untouched, clean, professional life, where he will get into, work hard and come out as a huge, in a very high level in the society. So I think these two yogas are enough for today. We will carry on with Lagnadi yogas in the coming, Suryadi yogas in the coming session, where I will be talking about Vesi yoga, Vasi yoga, Ubhayachara yoga and more to come. Thank you very much for today.